Welcome, students of class 9, to English literature class on the poem Ethics, chapter 8, part 5. In part 4 of the video, I had mentioned that is the last video with reference to explanation. Here, in this video, you will see that some of the questions asked earlier, you will find it is easier to write the answers with a little bit of guidance. Hence, in this video, I am providing you the necessary guidance to write some of the answers. Shall we proceed? So, over to the questions that were asked. Explain the meaning of the lines 16 to 25 of the poem. This I am sure you can do it. What did Linda understand or realize when she went to a real museum? Is the poem only about a lesson of ethics learnt in school, or does it offer something higher than this? Any answers? Yes, it offers higher. Let us see. Next question. List the ethics you would follow in the situations given below. Place of work, place of learning, class and school, place of worship, and place of living. This is where I felt you need a little bit of help. So we'll proceed one by one. Answers. Question 4. Which question is this? This is with regarding to, does it offer you anything more? Is ethics limited to classroom or it helps you more? The poem begins in a classroom and ends in a museum. This shows that ethics cannot be taught in classrooms. It is not something that you can be told you by heart this and you vomit this. It's not that easy. They should be taught through experience, as experience is a great teacher. Suppose, for instance, children in your class, you stole something. You're a small child, maybe the first standard. You stole the eraser of another child and you had a fight over it. The matter was taken to the teacher. Teacher could not handle it. It went to the principal. What will the principal do? He will first tell you, explain to you what you did is wrong. If you still don't understand, he'll call for your parents, he'll scold you, and he'll observe you next time. So what happens now is slowly you understand that stealing is wrong. What is not mine, I should not take, because the consequences or the results that I have to face may not be good. Nobody will like me. In the classroom, the instruction is to differentiate between good and bad or right and wrong behavior. It is an attempt to teach the children of acceptable and unacceptable behavior. Will you like anybody calling you a cheat, a robber, a thief, things like that? No. So you are you feel it very nice only when people appreciate you. That is acceptable. When you are not respected or liked because you do something wrong, it's unacceptable behavior. So these things you start learning through experience when you do it. So let's continue. As children grow and mature, they acquire wisdom. Old age is the time when old are to be taken care of and protected, as we take care of old objects of value in a museum. Do you go and keep any rubbish in the museum? No. Old objects which have a lot of value are preserved, kept with great care. So children, through this process of ethics, are taught that you who is young now grows into adolescence, and then you go into an adult, and then you mature, and still you grow further into an old person. So how you treat your grandparents at home is what you are going to treat your parents like. So this is something that passes from generation to generation, and you understand that it is just not about liking somebody, loving somebody, but how we are going to take care of them in the old age, value them. In other words, it's all about valuing, respecting, caring the old people. We hear people proudly speak of their 80 years old teak wood sofa, which they value. They should value or respect their elders of a similar age, instead of saying that it's okay if they die because they have lived their lives. So this is what has to be understood. Next we come to care, respect and value the experience of elders is important. Okay, so you have understood question 4. Question 5 was, how should you conduct yourselves in a place of work, your school, then where you live and at the worship area? In a place of work, we have to follow practical, behavioral and moral ethics. Three things you have to have. You have to be practical, what is possible, behavioral and moral ethics. Being punctual is practical. Going to school or going to your place of work on time and reporting there on time shows a very good quality of yours. Being friendly and cooperative is behavioral ethics. One should have integrity in the workplace, means we should be honest and morally upright. We will not do anything wrong in our workplace because that is the value we have been taught. We will not be dishonest, we will not cheat, but do our best in our workplace. Is that clear? Next, place of learning, school or class. Values of punctuality, discipline and obedience. Yes, as children, you're expected to be obedient because you don't know how to conduct yourselves. Respect the ideals of cleanliness and eco-consciousness. Yes, ideals of cleanliness, how to be clean, how to keep my surrounding clean, how to maintain personal hygiene, cut my nails, comb your hair. Why do the teachers insist on all this? Because when you are clean, when you look clean and presentable, your work is a lot is expected from you, and people think that will be the way you work also. Keeping your surroundings clean, keeping things in place. These are all qualities which have to be imbibed, and they can be done only at a tender age. Why do we sing a song, bits of paper lying on the ground makes the place untidy? Isn't it? You sing that rhyme, isn't it? Why is that poem taught to the children? So that if they see bits of paper lying around also, they pick it up and put it in the right place and keep the classroom clean. So this is cleanliness and eco-consciousness, a surrounding also. I feel like jumping suddenly now the teacher is teaching. I cannot jump. I may be dying to jump inside, but I'll have to hold on till the bell rings and I'm let loose. So doing what is required in the class, doing what others have to do in common, that we have to take care of. We cannot just behave like wild animals. Treat others with respect and help one another. This is what is expected. In a place of worship, maintain the serenity of the place by being silent and prayerful. Whenever you go to a temple, a mosque or a church, what do you observe there? Silence. You may have the sound of bells or the priest doing some puja, but nobody really talks to one another there. There is something calm and tranquil about the place. People are all in the posture of bending their heads and looking at the deity or praying. So maintain that. Don't go there and scream and shout. If you don't like to go there and keep quiet, you better be out of the temple, not inside. So be prayerful, respect. Do not talk about different other religions, mock the priest or mock something else there. Learn to respect the place. Learn to respect the silence. That is what it is about. Place of living. Wherever you live, keep the surroundings clean. We have heard many times, my house should be neat, but I don't care if my neighbor's is untidy. What do I mean by that? I take all the rubbish heaps from my house, throw it in the veranda of the neighbor house. That's called not in my backyard syndrome. That means you believe that my house in front should be spick and span. So what if I put a little dust on the other side? That is absolutely wrong. Keep your surroundings clean, not only your homes. Don't say anything that is common property, like in apartments and flats. You can't say inside my house is spick and span, but outside it is a common area. It's not my area. I will dirty it to the maximum. No. Maintenance of cleanliness in the surroundings. Strengthen human relationships. Be friendly, cordial, helpful if you can. But you want to be hurtful or you don't want to help, just keep quiet and move away. Try to bond with each other. Bond means become friendly, understanding, compassionate, and shower your love on others. These are some of the ethics, what you have been taught right from the classroom, which should lead up to the museum. Value everything that you get. A pencil, when you get in the nursery class or the first standard, you feel it's such a treasure. Learn to keep the value for that pencil till it finishes its complete life. Learn to use everything properly with care and with love. And it does not matter whether it is only a pencil or a pen. It goes to all living people also. Treat everyone with love, respect, compassion and care. I'm sure these answers will help you to answer the questions that have been given. Is that clear? Thank you, students.